Alright, so right out the box, this figure is absolutely gorgeous. It captures Cooler very well and is incredibly faithful to the source material. The action pose is almost identical to his dive kick from the movie with added effects. First glance, you can really feel the strength and ferocity of Cooler. I really like this line because their goal is to represent characters in dynamic poses at an affordable price, and this is precisely what they did and went further than my expectations. There's nice detailing on his helmet and armor to give it that organic exoskeleton texture. I like that the eyes aren't just red, but orange with red highlights around them, almost like a glowing effect. Even the back of the head has that texture mentioned earlier. They even put indents behind the spikes of his head. You'll notice that the armor pieces aren't just white, but have a gray shading around. He's got these huge shoulder pads that add to his imposing figure. Even the back, you'll see the shading and on the horns as well. I really like that for a fist, so much detail was put into it, the shading and the bone texture on his knuckles stretching the skin. He's got those weird alien feet that are in a super tense pose. Now, when Frieza was conquering planets, Cooler was hitting the gym. Such incredible amounts of shading and detailed sculpting was done to accentuate the muscles on his legs, abs, upper body, and even lower back. The bulbs that are on his armor is actually a translucent blue, nicely contrasting the rest of the character. His action base is absolutely beautiful. The rock formation looks like it's getting cratered in, and nicely painted to show the explosion rising from it. The explosion and energy is a translucent plastic, but what I like about it is that you can see all the vibrant colors included. The explosion shifts from orange to yellow, and the energy around his foot, which is pink, has yellow highlights. This is what the bottom of the base looks like. Surprisingly, this isn't a tall figure, only standing up at 8.5 inches tall. but he is lengthy. From tail end to toe, he's 11.5 inches, so he'll need some space around him. For a size comparison, here's him next to the 20th Film Edition Goku, BWFC Frieza, FiguartsZero Goku, and FiguartsZero Broly. In conclusion, this is an awesome figure. It accurately showcases the brute force that is Cooler. The figure itself is in such a dynamic pose, you can almost see the motion in action. The only thing that could have made this better was possibly a beat-up Goku to plant on his foot. I'm very happy with what I got, and I highly recommend this figure to any fan of Cooler or Dragon Ball Z in general. Tell me in the comment section below what you think of this figure, and if you haven't, how do you like it? Well, that's it for today's video, and I'll see you in the next one.